Hi, this is Dr. Anju Chilani. In this video, I will explain you how to swap two numbers using three different methods. So before I start with the swapping, first I want to give you a small intro how to write a simple command or how to take value from user and how we will display these values. So for that, first I will click on file, new file, and then I can start writing my code here. So first I will write, I will take one variable a, int, input, enter any number. This is a simple command through which I will take one number from user and I will display the same value in next line. Before you will execute this thing, you have to save your file. You can give any name to your file, let's do testing, and press F5 to execute this code. And now you can see your screen. Enter any number 5 and the same value will display here. So this is a very simple command which we have done just now. Using this line, let me explain you first. Enter any number, this is a message for user. Second, input means user will enter any value in integer, and a is your variable where user will store your value, and equal sign is for is your assignment operator which will help you to assign the value in a. In next line, the same value which user will enter in a, that will print here using print function. So this we have done. Now we will start with the swap coding. I have already done these codings so that I can explain you. Here is the code of swap 1, how to swap two numbers. This is the first code. Let me close this file first. And num1 equal to int input enter first number, num2 int input second number. It means we are asking user to enter two numbers. Let me explain you what is swap. Swap means to interchange the value. Means the value of num will copy into num2 and the value of num2 will display in num1. Interchange the value of two numbers. So using first line, I am taking first value from user which will store in first variable, that is your num1. In second line, again we are asking user to enter second number that will store in num2. Now we will have one more variable, that is temporary variable called temp. So using third variable, this coding will swap two numbers using third variable. So using third variable means I will take help of third variable. So initial first, in first line, this temp equal to num1, the value of num1 I will copy in temp. Now num1 is free, I can insert new value in num1. So in second line, in this num1 equal to num2, I will copy the value of num2 into num1. Now my num1, num2 is free because I have copied the value of num2 in num1. So now num2 is ready to take new value. So I will copy the value of temp into num2. So let's take one small example. Let me write it down here. If the num1 value is 5, is equal to 5. This is just an example. And the value of num2 is 6. When I will execute the first statement, this one, after executing this line, value of temp will become 5 and num1 will also be 5, because we always copy the value, we never cut the value. Value always travel from right to left, means num1 value will copy into temp. Same way, num1 value was 5, which I will copy in temp. Now after executing first line, we will start with the second part, second line, where we are copying the value of num2 into num1. So num2 value was 6. So now I have copied the original value in temp. So I can use num1 for some other purpose. So now the value of num1 can store value 6 and the previous value will overwrite. So now the value of num1 is 6 and value of num2 is also 6, but we have copied the value of num2 into num1. So now I can put new value in num2. So now in after writing this line is left, third line is left, where I will copy the original value of temp. The value of temp was 5, which I will copy in num2. So after writing the third statement, value of num2 will become 5 and temp is also 5. But now I have already swapped these two values. You can see here, earlier the value of num1 was 5, but here the value of num1 is 6 and the value of num2 was 6 here. Now after swapping, the value of num2 is 6. This is only to explain you have written all these things. Now after doing this calculation, we will display a message for user that value we have already successfully swapped. So now we can print the final answer. So for that I will again write the print statement. Print means whatever you want to display on the screen, that you have to write inside the double inverted comma as it is. And if you want to display some value of variable, that you will not write inside the double inverted comma. So print value of first and second number after swapping. Print first number equal to num1 means first number equal sign will display as it is along with the value of num1. This slash n means this part will display in the next line. Slash n means to display value in next line. So second number equal sign will display as it is but in next line. And num2 means the value of num2 will display here. So let's execute this code. For this I will press F5, OK for saving, and let's see what will be the output. Now see, they will ask me enter first number. Show you. See, can you see the code here? Enter first numbers. Same message I am getting here. So I have entered 5. I will press enter button. Enter second number. This enter second number here. The same message is displaying here. Now 7 number is my second number. When I will press enter, I will get the print message as it is. It was given in the coding. Value first and second after swapping. Now you can see value has been swapped. This was the first method through using third variable, swap using third variable. Now we will do it the same coding, swap two numbers without using third variable. Now we don't have temp in this coding, as you can see here. In first two lines I am taking value from user. Num1, the same value of num1 is 5, you can assume it. And in num2, the value of second value we are taking, which we will store in num2. Let me explain you here. And these are the calculation which we will do it, and after that we will find the value has been swapped. So let's take example. Num1 is my 5 and value of num2 is 6. User will enter these two. Let's assume user has entered these two values. Now we will execute this thing. Num1 plus num2 equal to num1. It means whatever will be the value of num1 will be added with num2 and we will store in num1. So here the value of num1 is 5, num2 is 6, And if I will copy these two values, my new value will be 11. 11. It means the new value of num1 is 11. Num1 is equal to 11. Now, let's do second line. Value of num2. We have to find out. So, value of num1, new value of num1 was 11. So, I will write here 11 minus value of num2 is 6. So, I can write here 6. 11 minus 6 is equal to 5. So, I can write here the new value of num2 is 5. I hope this is clear to everyone. And the last line is, now again I have to find out the value of num1. So num1 equal to, now the new value of num1 was 11 and new value of num2 was 5. So let me deduct 11 minus 5 is equal to 6. It means the new value of num1 is 6 and the value of num2 is now 5. So you can see here the num2 value was 6 earlier, now it is 5, and the value of num1 was 5, now it is 6. So let me execute this code, and after doing this calculation, the same way you will display message to user so that user can find out you have swapped both values. For this I will press F5 and OK button. Now again the same message will display here, enter first number and second number. Let me see. Yeah, it's here 5 and 8. You can see value has been swapped, 8 and 5. And let's do the last version, last way how to swap value using third method. This is the most easiest way. After doing this code, I believe you will not try the first and the second method, but this is the plus point of Python which we will do it here. See, using first line I am taking again the first value from the user, second line will take second value from user, and now this is the best way to swap any number, num1 comma num2 equal to num2 comma num1. It means the value of num2 will copy in num1 and value of num1 will copy in num2 simultaneously, and that's it. After this, when you will display the final answer, you will get the swapped value. Press F5, OK button. Now again this part will execute. They will ask, see here, enter value. Let me take some other number, 9 and 4. See, first number is 4 and the last number is 9. So this is it guys. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Till then, happy coding.